Now, it is time to talk about that epic French sulk. They're sulking because we left the EU. They're sulking particularly because a load of their fishermen seem to think that us leaving the EU would make no difference to their right to fish in British sovereign waters. Well, it turns out it does make a big difference, and that we haven't given lots of their trawlers licenses to fish in our waters because they're ours. We've given about 12, but we've turned down quite a few as well. So we have handed out some licenses, but many have not been granted. The trawlermen have now gone into a sulk, and they say they're going to blockade the port of Calais and blockade the Channel Tunnel in a deliberate bid to cause shortages and ruin the British Christmas. Isn't that nice? What do you think about that? 0344 499 1000. Let's talk to Samuel Armstrong at the Henry Jackson Society. Good evening, Samuel.
Evening, Kev.
Yeah, this is the epic French sulk chapter about seven, isn't it? There's so many reasons they're sulking with us. They're sulking with us, I think, originally because we left Brexit in the first place. They're sulking with us because we made forward plans for vaccines and they didn't. So our vaccine rollout is a triumph. Theirs is a disaster. They're sulking with us because of AUKUS, because we took away their submarine deal with Australia, because we joined up with America and offered them nuclear submarines, nuclear-powered submarines, as opposed to the chugging old French diesel models. And now they're sulking with us because of fishing rights. They seemed to think that us leaving the EU would make absolutely no difference to all of their trawlers fishing in our waters. Well, newsflash, it does. So now that so many of their fishermen haven't got their licenses, they're sulking again. They're going to blockade Calais and cause misery in this country. At least that is their intention. What are we going to do about this Gallic sulk, these miserable French people?
Yeah, well, look, we should be really clear about what's going on with these fishermen. We said, look, for 30, 40 years, we realised you've been fishing in our waters, and many of you have grown up into the fishing trade, fishing in our waters, French fishermen. So, look, fair play, we're leaving the EU, there are waters now, but as part of the negotiation, as a gesture of goodwill almost, we said, look, if you're a French fisherman and you can prove that in the last few years, at least, you've been fishing in our waters, fine, you can carry on. And indeed, many French fishing boats have been given licenses to continue fishing in the UK waters, in Jersey waters, in Guernsey waters, all fine. What is going on is there is a series of French fishermen who can't, for whatever reason, either they haven't been doing it or they can't show it, they haven't shown that they've been fishing here. And accordingly, they put in for their licenses and they were rejected. They had no right. They couldn't show that they were historic. So as part of our unpicking, these are exactly the sorts of people we were going to exclude moving forward. You've not fished here, so you can't fish here now. But if these people aren't prepared to go through the paperwork and get it done and prove their case that they've been fishing here, why should we be fishing them? And then you get these ridiculous protestations, not just from the French fishermen, which would be bad enough, but from the French government, who are threatening to turn off the electricity interconnectors, who are threatening to cut us off. These aren't just mere sulks. They are at times bordering on what, in a different conflict, we might even call acts of war.
Well, there's certainly, it's like a temper tantrum. I mean, you know, it seems to feed into the Gallic temperament. So it was said after their epic temper tantrum following the AUKUS debacle, where they lost their multi-billion-pound contract to build old chugging diesel submarines for Australia, and we came in and offered them nuclear-powered submarines along with the Americans. So Australia said, no, thank you, monsieur, we'll go with the British and the Americans. I mean, it was said that they were so sulky after that it proves why France can never really be taken as a serious superpower, that they have this tendency to be a bit childish in these situations. And frankly, the reaction of these fishermen is childish. to say we're going to block the Channel Tunnel and we're going to block Calais to ruin Christmas for British people is childish. It's infantile. We were just watching earlier while we were speaking, Sam, the footage of the, it was in May, the blockade they tried to do in the Channel Islands. Again, a bit sort of tempestuous, a bit childish. They ought to keep a bit of a lid on their temper, don't you think? Don't you think they ought to wind their necks in a bit, be a bit more diplomatic about these situations?
Yeah, I do. And look, you're right to point out France views itself as a superpower, this old imperial nation that's still a big deal on the nation, on the global scene. And then it sometimes conducts itself almost a little bit more like Russia or China, throwing its toys out the pram, beginning to make threats and actions that go beyond threats. And we saw just today, actually, that there was a story come out that during the vaccine row, France literally blocked a deployment
of
5 million vaccines to the UK. AstraZeneca vaccines invented in Britain, given over to AstraZeneca, a pan-European company to build and create. France was so put out at the Brits having done this better. They blocked these vaccines that were rightfully ours, and accordingly, they were delivered to the UK. And Kev, I don't say this lightly, but when those vaccines didn't arrive, people didn't get vaccinated, they got COVID, and they died.
People died. And don't forget, before that, Macron tried to denigrate the AstraZeneca vaccine because it was, of course, British from Oxford. And he sort of denounced it as something that wouldn't help anyone who was over the age of 60 and was, in fact, a dodgy vaccine. There was absolutely no scientific basis to what he said. He was merely saying it because it was British. And frankly, to tell people that this was an ineffective vaccine was epically irresponsible on his part. And the only reason he did it is because he doesn't like the Brits. And they've got to grow out of this innate hatred of us that leads them to do such irresponsible, childish things.
Yeah, look, you're absolutely right. It's hurt both French people and British people. And look, it frankly puts Macron in a bad place. He sees himself as this grand centrist, levitating above it statesman. And actually, he resembles, I've just got back from Conservative Party conference. There were some strange men outside. One of them wasn't wearing any shoes. And then there was Piers Corbyn, who was Jeremy Corbyn's brother. They were handing you out leaflets saying the vaccines are trying to control your brain through microchips and whatnot. And look, Macron's in the same boat as the nutters that are stood outside conference.
He was at one point.
And look, France, come on. Come on. You are a grand nation. You have built amazing things. You've done amazing things in global history. Why are you demeaning yourself to this level just to get one over on your old rival? Because we might just be making a little bit much of its success out of Brexit.
You might hope that the French authorities, in fact, the French government, would try to dissuade the trawler men and the fishermen, and I guess women as well, must be careful here, from blockading the Channel Tunnel, blockading Calais in a deliberate bid to ruin Christmas for us. You might hope that the government might say, come on now, this is going too far. But I wouldn't bet the farm on it, would you?
They seem to be encouraging them. It almost takes us back to the days of ancient history when the French and British conducted war through privateers, in which we got licensed men of the seas to go out and conduct raids on the other side, to blockade their ports, to take ransoms from the others. We seem to have gone back 300-400 years with the French deciding to themselves that actually, look, we are going to encourage it, but look, let's be clear. Why the French government is doing this is because they are terrified of their own people. This is what people forget about France. They have revolutions like we have elections at times in French history. Yeah. They're terrified of their people saying, the harvest is awful, the fish and catch is dreadful. Right, let's all march from Paris and take over and little old Macron will send him to the guillotine. So you do have to feel sorry at times, I think, for the French government. But look, I think we can do a little bit better in this modern age, can't we?
I would hope so. The thing about France is I love France. I love the food. I like the people whenever I go there. I love the country. But I think their attitude to us is inspired by deep jealousy. They're jealous of us because we're better than them. We're always better in wars. We're better at everything apart from possibly football. But the old rivalry between the British and the French, I think, is doomed and destined to go on forever. Sam, great to talk. Always a pleasure. Samuel Armstrong there from the Henry Jackson Society.